before I was a teacher, I worked as an NGO in refugee camps, and I was actually at the Rwandese refugee camps in 1994 in Tanzania, and the whole story is based on my true experiences with those kids. I was working with these Kasulu street kids, so the kids you will see on stage are their characters, the characters are real. And there was one family of little kids, and there was one particular boy who was about 11 or 12 at the time, who, as the story tells, had got involved with a criminal element. They killed him, and they killed him by hanging him on a tree. I was actually involved with getting him down. And it was just a story that had to be told. The story is not about the genocide at all. It is about what happens afterwards. And it's about how kids get caught up in what adults do. And it's about how they deal with it, what happens, and what's the effect on them. And it's these kids who don't have a voice. Nobody else is telling their story. And it was just this visual image of this little kid. I just thought, his story has to be told. It just has to be told. And I think that's a real driving force with both of us.
And in terms of where we want to continue to go is to give voices to these children.
Yeah.
Irrelevant of their geographical location or religion or culture or tribe, there are so many fascinating, gripping stories out there for audiences to be exposed to and to learn about, to be educated by, that we as writers and composers are inspired to try and find those stories and to share them. Mm. Those stories deserve to be told and deserve to be heard, and those little lives deserve, I guess, to be celebrated.
Mm. And respected through the medium of the arts, and I think a musical captures that so beautifully. That story had sat in my head for a very, very long time. So meeting Anna was then just a catalyst. I would have a scene in the story, and Anna would write the music, and the music would come back, and it would be perfect. Every single song just captured it, and it was a fantastic creative process. The kids who are performing on the stage, I mean, they have learned themselves so much.
And they've talked to me very passionately at times about the Syrian crisis at the moment, and the child refugees in those refugee camps. They are tuning in to the BBC 6 o'clock news and telling me about it the next day.
Many of them actually have to study the Rwandan genocide as part of their history, and this has really brought it to life for them, that it's a real story, it's true, it's not just the history books, it's actually really happening. And many of them have gone off and now read books and biographies and all sorts of things to research deeper into the actual story, because it's been brought to life for them.
To teach these stories and these messages to the younger generation will impact on them and their understanding of other global issues as they grow up and may well become future leaders and want to stop conflict and prevent these situations from happening in the first place.